Thank you, Dr. Naren, for the kind introduction. I'll be talking about Markerless Toric Surgery and how to optimize its outcome. So when we do a toric intraocular lens, we have to select our patients carefully, do a proper calculation, the axis marking. It also involves a proper intraoperative alignment and postoperative assessment. All these steps are very important to get the appropriate outcome. In these process, the errors can occur at any step, including the errors in measurement, execution, and planning. Here, I'll be talking about mainly the execution error, which involves the axis marking. So traditionally, the toric axis marking was done manually, and with time, different techniques like femtosecond laser-assisted marking, various image-guided systems, iris fingerprinting techniques, and abrometry-based methods have evolved. So in the traditional method, we make the patient sit in upright position to prevent cyclotorsion, because the cyclotorsion of the eye from upright to supine position could change from 2 to 4 degrees on average, but can go up to 15 degrees also. There are various options available for this manual marking, and it can be done as a primary step in the OPD, and it can be confirmed in the OT using these reference markers and a reference marking axis circle and the marker level. But here what happens is, when you use a marking pen, sometimes this mark gets smudged, it becomes broader than intended. The slit lamp, when used for marking, the beam might not be appropriate. If you put paracaine after the procedure or while cleaning the patient, it gets washed off. And while positioning the patient also, it needs to be in the straight upright position with the chin touching the base and the head resting on the headrest. Sometimes when there is a little head tilt either to the right or left, or you have a little uncooperative patient, these might cause errors in the marking. Now, these marking errors have resulted in reducing the outcome postoperatively. There was a study done where these four manual marking methods were evaluated. They used a needle-based marker, a bubble marker, a pendulum marker, and a tonometer marker. And they found that all these manual marking methods deviated slightly in terms to the horizontal reference meridian. And this, as I said, reduces the outcome of our toric IOL. Till now, we had this literature which said that for every degree the lens is rotated off axis, there's a 3.3% loss of effectiveness of the toric power. But a recent analysis says that the total loss of astigmatic correction can occur with as less as 20 degrees of misalignment and with 10 degrees of toric IOL rotation. So that makes it even more important for us to evolve. As our surgeries have evolved, we also need to evolve in terms of getting our accurate outcome. This is how the different imaging systems came into account. There are various available options like the Callisto image guided system, the Varian image guided system, Optiwave refractive analysis or ORA, which is an abrometry based system, femtosecond laser marking system, and iris fingerprinting technique. These image-guided systems not only help us in the marking the axis, they also guide us in placing the corneal incisions, centration and sizing of the rexus, as well as IOL centration. At our center, we have the Callisto marking system, so I'll be going a little more in detail about that. This can be paired with IOL Master 700, and there's a Callisto refractive suite available. They have a Zeiss forum, which has an EQ workplace with which we can micromanage things. So once the image is captured on the IOL Master 700, we need to make sure that we get a good reference image. A good reference image includes that both the limbus superior as well as inferior is very well exposed. The details of the iris and blood vessels are clearly seen, and the image is well centered. Anywhere where there are disturbances in the image, or the lids are covering the limbus portion, or if it is defocused or a decentered image, such images should not be used, not just for the reference marking, but also to get your proper keratometry. If you have a good exposure, your keratometry would also be perfect, and there won't be any exclamation mark talking about the quality of image being bad or anything. So once this image is taken, it goes to the Zeiss forum or their EQ workplace. There, through the LAN network, it can directly be shifted to the microscope. on the microscope, if you go to the patients and click on the document selected over there, you will see this reference image. Now, suppose during the preoperative planning, this reference image was not good, you can call the patient again or on the day of the surgery, get a good reference image prior to taking the patient to OT. Once you open these images, it gets directly exported to the patient's data. There in the patient preparation, you can add in furthermore details if you want, like confirming the eye, check for the IOL master data, whether the quality of the scan, the IOL power, everything is okay. Prepare your incisions based on the axis that you want to intend, whether you want a temporal incision or move it so little superior or inferior based on the astigmatism. You can mark your axis and centration. Once all this is done, you can verify everything in the summary of the patient. And then you just need to click on the start treatment option just before starting the surgery. When you do that, you'll have these markings for the toric. You can have this display on throughout your surgery, or you can just turn it on while putting the IOL. Like you can see here, the 0180 mark, which we had done for reference, is corresponding exactly with the 0180 mark, which comes on Callisto. And in the end, the final marking can be accurate. You can see the 0180, which was marked using a marker pen, is actually not a single degree axis, but it overlaps almost up to extending up to 5 degrees. So now if we have similar marking done for our toric and using only that as the reference mark, we could go 5 degrees here and there as well. So the different studies which were there in the literature say that these image-guided systems reduce the misalignment of toric IOL much more in comparison to manual axis. And they indicate not just the toric alignment, there is a difference in terms of the vector and vector of the post-operative astigmatism or outcome that you receive. So it improves your outcome also in compared to your manual marking method. Now, the femtosecond laser machines have also come up with this toric marking. On the Catalyst system, there is an option of intrastromal marking for axis alignment. You can see here faint marks of the intrastromal axis marking, which is there. The issue with these intrastromal marking is sometimes they might be slightly faint. And suppose the pupil is not very well dilated, it might obstruct your view for the axis placement. So the LENSAR system also comes with another option where these marking can be done on the capsular axis itself. A case report which was published regarding the same shows that aligning along the axis mark on the capsular axis also gives you good outcome with toric. So that is also one of the options, that the toric marking can be done on the anterior capsule also. This iris fingerprinting technique was introduced by Dr. Robert Osher. In this, using the Micron imaging system, a good quality digital photograph is taken of the patient, and based on the crypts and pits on the iris, the marking, your reference marking can be done. This has to be done in a fully dilated pupil so that it simulates the condition in the OT also. Abrometry based methods like ORA and another method like Holo's intraop have also been there for a few years now. On the ORA system, you can get the power as well as axis of toric IOL. The advantage is that it gives you the real-time assessment of phakic, aphakic, and pseudophakic refraction. On the Holo's intraop system, of toric IOL can be marked. I'll just take 2 minutes more. In addition to this, there's Zaldivar toric caliper, which is based on iTrace Tracy refraction system. There also a good quality digital imaging with the use of that. You can do a 3-point marking system where you can mark whatever landmarks you want. And the same image can be used in OT as the reference mark for your axis. In order to optimize outcome with these digital imaging system, it is good to do your surgical planning properly so that the errors in measurements and planning is reduced. You have to get a good reference image to ensure adequate exposure of the limbus, have good focused image. intraoperative alignment should be proper along the axis, and make sure that the visco wash is done in a proper way so that the immediate postoperative rotation is minimized. And always double check before you close the surgery, before you remove the drape, or maybe before the patient leaves the OR. It can be checked again using the slit lamp system. So to summarize, I would say that markerless toric axis marking system is the need of the hour to give the best outcome for our patient. It uses a good reference mark for accuracy. It gives you real-time assessment. However, these equipments are extremely costly compared to manual marking techniques. In cases of RK cuts or corneal edema, they might interfere with your view. But then as our surgeries are evolving, so we need to evolve with time to give the best for our patients. Thank you.